music, product, whatever you want to call it, finding a new way to get that out. It might be, you know, on a podcast. It might be, it's probably not going to be on radio, is what I'm saying.
That's
although the most recent figures still show that terrestrial radio is the number one, remains the number one music discovery source. And I think that's enlightening, given all the things that we all feel about the way radio has devolved.
You know, I don't know if I agree with that, but I mean, I think that my kids, for instance, have no use for radio. They
nor have I personally. But,
right.
You know,
they're, you know, my kids. It's all peer to peer. It's that kind of thing, and their radio is podcasts. Their radio is, you know. And there's still
Sirius,
okay, yeah,
yeah, kind of, except, you know,
I mean, you know, a few of the jocks, if you got something really good to Vince Scalzo or Meg Griffin, there's still the possibility that he or she would be able to get it on the air. But it's not a big possibility. It's not like back in the day.
I'm not even, I mean, at least, you know, I have a 12-year-old, and she doesn't know what a podcast is. She just goes right to YouTube.
Okay, that too.
Yeah. And that kills me because A, it's married to picture of some sort, which, and it's the audio quality is miserable. Just miserable. You know, it's just like I want her to hear stuff. I want her to, but you know, I suppose it's mostly Ariana Grande, so what does it matter? But I keep hoping she'll get into Led Zeppelin at some point.
It's also sad about college radio because when I was a teenager, college radio was super huge. Like 88.7 WHU, every Saturday night we sat there and waited to hear the metal show because no one else was doing it. It was 4 hours or 6 hours of metal, and it was huge. The DJs were rock stars locally.
You're a metalhead?
No. I like everything. But
he spoke.
Honestly, like 10 years ago, I was able to get a song played on WCCC. Now where are they? They're gone.
You should do some Christian music.
Yeah, she's Christian music. That's my real name. But honestly, like, I think that you have to go about it a different way now. Like, a lot of people are saying the digital age. Like, I'm actually a naysayer. I'm with Gene Simmons. I'm with Lars Ulrich. I'm with all these people that say that. I used to have a different mindset on it, but I think it killed our career. It killed the musician's career. It really did. Downloading and all that stuff, all the internet stuff. I used to go out and flyer the streets, and that's when people were curious. Like, oh, what is this band? Why do they have that logo? Why do they look like that? I'm going to go check them out. Now, it's so easily accessible that no one goes, it eliminates the thought process of maybe I'll go check them out live, or maybe I'll buy the album and wonder about their lyrics. Everything is in plain black and white, right in front of your face, and it leads us to an ADD world. Where kids have, the song's gotta be 2 minutes long, otherwise it's too long for them to care. And I don't think that that internet is a good thing as much as I thought it used to be. It's good if you wanna get out there for free at a promo level, but if you wanna make a career out of this, I hate to say it, but it's not great.
Well, I mean, but knowing that, what you're saying, no, like, knowing the end user attention span is really short, you really only have that much of a moment to actually captivate those people, because they're the futures buying your music regardless of how, whatever format it's going to be. So you really have to pigeon toe, I think, or like categorize and make sure that end user is the one that's going to be listening for those 2 minutes, even if it's 30 seconds. You've got to captivate them to get them there and stay there.
And the live show too. Sell your CDs at the live show. That's
That this is entirely new either, in the sense that, I mean, at least with popular radio, there was a sense that you had 15 seconds to capture your listener with the next song, or they were going to push the button to go to the competitor radio station. And, you know, that's not in the 60s and 70s where long form, you know, jams were acceptable. But certainly in the 80s.
Lee Abrams basically instituted the idea that if you're not playing,